Hi! In this video we are going to do an easy DIY lightsaber. First of all, we are doing the handle. There's a lot of ways to do it, with wood or plastic tubes, but I decided to do it with metal. What we need for this is some tubes with different diameters that could be inserted one inside the other one. The first thing that we are doing is measuring and cutting the tubes that we are using for the handle. In this case I did it of 25 cm. Now we cut about 10 cm of another tube that fits inside the first one. This one will hold the blade of our lightsaber. Now we make a diagonal cut. This will make it looking nicer and more similar to the ones that appear in the movies. For putting the tubes together we can use some gloss tape, and then welding them. I'm not a really good welder. If you know someone that knows how to do it better, you will get a nicer piece. Now we remove the dross and sand the surface. And for ending with the handle we make some holes and make them through with the screw trap. That's where we will put the screws that will hold the blade. I'd made 6 holes, but with 8 we will have a stronger holding. Now we have the handle done, let's make the blade. We will need a tube that will make us a structure, another one thinner where we will put the LEDs, a multicolor LED stripe, a battery, some wire, a switch or a wireless LED switch, and some materials to blur the lights of the LEDs, as packaging plastic or vegetal paper. The first thing that we are doing is cutting the tubes at the lengths that we want that our blade will be. I did it of 85 cm. Now we cut the LED stripe twice the length of our blade, and we stick it itself, making the LEDs pointing out. For welding the connections we will have to remove a piece of the rubber protection of the LEDs. Now we can weld the wires to the LED stripe. I recommend you to use wires with different colors and welding both sides of the LED stripe. I used it black for the positive 12 volts and the color of each LED with the same wire color. Then to protect the connection we can use hot glue. Once we have the weld done we have to blur the lights of the LEDs. For doing this we will roll the LED stripe inside the packaging plastic. This material is not the best to blur the lights, probably you can find a better material for this. Now we can put it inside the first tube. It's important to check that all LED's colors are working well and any one hasn't broken. Now we will use some more plastics to blur better the lights. Then we will put it inside the bigger tube. For finishing the blade, we will cut a piece of plastic at the same diameter of the tube and we will stick it to the tube. We have the most important parts of our lightsaber. Now we have to put them together with screws. If them are too long, we will have to cut them. Now we can put the blade in the handle and hold it with the screws. Another essential part of this project is the power supply for the LEDs. There's a lot of ways to connect the battery with the LEDs. We can connect them directly, put a switch to turn on and off the lights and changing the color by changing the wires, or using a different switch for each color. In this case I will use a remote switch that comes with the LED stripe. As the box can enter inside the handle, I had to open it and take the board out of it. In this board we can see the power supply of 12 volts, the wires that goes to the LEDs and the antenna. The first thing that we are doing with the board is removing this big connector, and as I saw that there was a broken wire, I also welded it to the board. Now we cut some wires that we'll use as power supply to the board and weld them to a connector. In this case I'm using a DIN connector. And we protect them with a heat shrink. Now we weld the wires of the connector to the board, being careful with the polarity. As this battery had a different connector, I had to weld a DIN once to it. Finally, we weld the LED stripe to the board, or to some 1-pin connector for an easier assembling and disassembling. Now we connect the LED stripe and the battery and we check that the remote control works well. If everything is okay, we can fix the board with some hot glue. As the remote needs to see the antenna for working well, we have to make a hole to the handle. If you want to decorate the handle, you could hide the antenna. Then we have to check that everything fits well inside the handle. And finally for making the cap we are going to cut a piece of a tube and an iron sheet and we will weld them. We also will make some holes and through it with a screw tap. We fix the cap and we check that everything works well. There we have our lightsaber. I have made two, and with a piece of a tube with some screws and some cables to duplicate the power, we can put them together and make a double lightsaber. There is our lightsaber or our double lightsaber.